What's going on, guys, and welcome to Rubes Squad. If you're new here, hi, hello, bonjour, my name is Bres and I make Apex Legends content. So the anniversary collection event just launched yesterday to celebrate Apex's 3rd year anniversary, and there's some really cool skins in the event, including the first ever mythic skin, the evolving Bloodhound skin. But is the event worth it? Are the skins worth the price for a regular Apex player like you and me? That's what I wanted to go over, because most of the big streamers and YouTubers will obviously buy out the whole collection event and just simply write it off as income expenditure, because they make money from creating Apex content, so it only makes sense to invest in Apex for them. In case you didn't know it already, some of the skins in the event are actually community made skins, modeled after some of the creators, inspired by some of the creators. Like this Octane one, this Octane skin which is in the tracker was made by an artist inspired by Timmy, who's a really cool streamer, and Shroud's little brother. Lulu, the Creeper Queen, also has her own 301 skin, an Epic skin, and the Gaming Merchant, a very creative Apex YouTuber, got an Epic Rampage skin. If you look at it closely, these are the colors he uses for his video thumbnails, blue and yellow, and at the back side it says Cheerio, which is something he says at the end of his videos. So anyway, what I'm saying is that these creators will have a biased opinion on the event. No hate to them, I absolutely respect them. They grinded hard and achieved legendary status, and now they're enjoying the fruits of their labor. I mean, if I had my own skin in Apex, I'd literally be willing to pay the salaries of half of the dev team. So are the skins worth it? Honestly, I think some of them are really cool. I love the concept of matching skins. Imagine if you had a full 3-stack and all of you had those matching Hypebeast, Crypto, Watson and Mirage skin, that would be so cool. But if you're a Bloodhound main and only want the Prestige skin, I don't think it's worth spending 16,000 Apex coins to get it. Maybe wait till it goes in the heirloom store and you could get heirloom shards and craft it. I made a video on how to get heirloom shards much faster, so check that out, it's linked in the description. Just be patient, because honestly, some people have an opinion that there are some Bloodhound legendaries which are so much cooler, and I agree, like the White Wintry Color or the OG Halloween one. And a big part of the community is against this collection event, which I'm very happy to see. So in conclusion, I'm happy that Apex is celebrating its 3rd year. The game is pretty much alive and will be for a long time, obviously. I love that King's Canyon is back in rotation. I don't remember the last time I played there, because I'd taken a break from Apex last season. And if you're just a kid or you don't have that much money, don't stress. Don't go out of your way to steal your parents' credit card to buy the $160 skin or something like that. It's not really worth that price point. You may be watching all these content creators getting every skin, but most of us don't have that kind of money to spend on video games, and that's okay, you know? Though if you're rich, by all means, go ahead and support the game. I'm not telling you how to spend your money. Keep on keeping Apex alive. Though it's very sad that we all know EA has more money than God at this point, and they could afford to just put the skin in the store for 4,000 Apex coins, or even 5,000, and get more sales. Or even make it so you could choose whether you want the skin after collecting all your packs, all your event packs, or you just want the heirloom shards. But what do I know? I'm just a college student that makes YouTube videos in his free time. Once again, I'm very happy and I love the fact that many people in the community, even content creators such as Lulu and Junks, are against this $160 skin, adding to the fact that it's a first person skin and your enemies will get to see it more than you. This reminds me of the Iron Crown collection event, the most scummy collection event in the history of Apex. It was in season 2 and it was the first ever collection event, and you literally couldn't buy or craft the legend skin that you wanted. You had to buy the Apex packs and have a 1 in 24 chance of getting the skin that you want. And to make it worse, once you'd bought all the event packs, you still had to pay 3000 Apex coins to finally unlock the Bloodhound heirloom. It was so greedy, because not even a real axe cost that much. Luckily, the community spoke out and things got much better to what we have now. Anyway, that's my opinion on the collection event. Let me hear yours in the comments. Please leave the video a like if you liked it. It helps me out a lot. And thanks so much to all of you. Sahib, Huzaifa, Osislol, Chonko, many others. I always see you in the comments of all my videos, and you people are literally the reason I'm getting more traffic. So thank you very much. I love you guys. And consider subscribing if you're new. That's all from me. I'll see you in the next one. Have a lovely day. Ciao. I just wanna tell you. Congratulations. Celebrate.